Hello, how are you? I am feeling a bit sick today, but I wanted to make this video anyway to share with you something that I feel quite inspired sharing, and I think it might be helpful or intriguing to you to consider. So, a couple of days ago, a client of mine emailed me and she wrote that she felt quite confused about something she wanted to do. Like, she wasn't sure that if she wanted to do it or not. It was about going to another country. Let's say Japan. It wasn't Japan, but let's say it was. So she had this dream of going to Japan and living there, and she thinks she would feel very well there. But she's not sure. Is it her intuition telling her to go to Japan? Or maybe she was just telling herself to go there and she's confused about it. Is it just inspired idea, intuition? Or maybe just her mind is telling her to go, but it's not the right move for her. Like, can you hear it? That it's a lot of kind of mental noise there. It's busy mind. And I thought, it's so true to me also, and perhaps to all of us, that we become really busy minded and we try to figure things out. And then often we try to figure out if something, like, is the right decision inspired by our intuition, by our wisdom, or not. And it looks to us as if one way to go was the correct one, the one that will lead us to well-being and success and happiness. And the other way to go, or all the other options we have, are wrong decisions. So they will lead to some sort of unhappiness. And two reflections here. First of all, I find it very helpful when I feel like that my mind is very busy, that I feel tense maybe in my body or restless. This is just a signal to stop listening to my thoughts. Stop engaging with them. Because inspiration or intuition or wisdom will not be found there. When the mind is busy, like, and there is sort of tense feeling in us, the chances are very small that something insightful, creative, productive will come out of it. So the best I know is really to just disengage with your thinking, just stop listening to those thoughts. You can come back to listening to your head when you feel better, when you feel calmer and clearer. And we can do it. We can choose to ignore our thoughts or not take them seriously. Have little distance to them. Because intuition usually comes in a form of kind of quiet knowing. Just knowing beyond the shadow of a doubt. Just knowing inside our heart that we want something. And it doesn't need to be logical. It doesn't need to be approved by anyone or even by our own mind. We just know. Or sometimes it comes, at least to me and to many people I spoke with, sometimes it comes just as fresh idea, something that feels fresh and inspiring, and it is worth exploring. Or sometimes it comes a certain feeling in the body, like being connected to something greater, and then you know, you feel certain. But in all of it, it doesn't come from the busy mind, it doesn't come from the intellect, from the thinking. And the second reflection is about decisions and our ideas that there is wrong decision and bad decision. Ooh, this is a big one for most of people. Like sometimes we spend so much time worrying like what to do because one decision is good, the other is bad. Or even after we made a decision, we can get anxious. Was it the right decision or not? And this just brings so much more unnecessary mental noise and tense feeling that just clutters us, clutters our minds, our bodies, our hearts, where we could have more space for insight and fresh idea, fresh thinking. So I would suggest that there is no such thing as wrong or bad decision in most cases. Yes, sometimes, maybe, perhaps sometimes there is, but if there is, usually it's clear, like, no, this is wrong, this is right. But I'm talking about like more casual choices, like, shall I quit my job or not? Shall I write a book or shall I, I don't know, put my energy somewhere else? Shall I stay with my boyfriend or shall we break up? These kind of choices. It seems to me that whatever choice we make, the wisdom will still be there for us to guide us and to show us something. Whichever way we choose, our well-being is not dependent on the choice or on the outcome of this decision. Because our well-being, our sense of enjoyment of life is inside. It's not dependent on being in Japan or not being in Japan. And another thing, sometimes we have this intuitive nudges, like something feels right, fresh, worth exploring. And we have like two choices. We can follow this idea and see what happens, we can play with it, or we can just start really considering, is it my intuition, is it my wisdom, or maybe I'm just making it up. And then in a way we are stuck, we are not engaged with life, we are just standing and waiting. And I think that we are here in life to live. So that's why I think it's wonderful to engage in our inspired, creative ideas. So let's say someone wants to go to the Japan. Great! It's great to explore, you know, what does it take to go to Japan? It's great to start looking for work there or learning about the country. And as you do it, you might discover that you actually don't want to go there. Or you might discover that you want to go there. Or you might discover that you want to go somewhere else or stay where you are. If so, does it mean that it was wrong idea, that it wasn't your intuition? No, not at all. In that moment, it was true for you. You wanted in that moment to go to Japan. So you engaged with this creative idea and you learned something. And I'm sure whether you learned or not, or you changed your mind, you learned something. You moved somewhere. And these creative ideas can change, can shift, but once we engage with what is fresh, what is alive, we learn. We are in the game of life. We are interacting with life. And we always learn, and we always move forward and see more. So I'll give you an example from my life. For instance, I'm writing a book now, and the concept of the book has changed, I think, 3 times now. And you know, always when a new concept came, it felt like my intuition was telling me to go in that direction. It felt inspired and fresh. So I explored that concept and I was writing. And then it changed the concept. But it doesn't mean that it was wrong, that it wasn't intuition, that it wasn't inspiration. It was. It invited me to explore something in that direction. I did, and then it changed. So we can be, I think, much more lighthearted about our decisions and much more explorative and much more engaged in life. At least to me, it seems like more natural, more fun, and more prone to success way of living. So I hope it was helpful or interesting, or maybe not. If you have any questions or comments, I'd love to hear them. Have a great day and see you soon next time. Bye.